Silencio!
I would like to welcome everybody to the virtual branch of the Massapequa Public Library, where we bring you the finest in swing and big band music. And today we have Phil Costa and the Something Special Big Band. So let's welcome them and let's go!
1, 2, 3,
that tune was Things Ain't What They Used To Be, and unfortunately for some of us how true that is, but hopefully today we're going to make them a little better and perhaps bring back some old memories. This is the Something Special Band. We're going to play a smorgasbord of big band music, anywhere from 1940 to more recent times, and hopefully there'll be a favorite in there somewhere for you. I just want to caution you, we're going to take an intermission of about 10-15 minutes, so there will be a second half, so if you deem worthwhile hearing, please stay with us. We want to begin our program today with probably one of the most famous of the big bands ever, the Glenn Miller Band. Now, of course, everything that Glenn Miller did was a hit, and we kind of got tired of playing In the Mood and things like that. I've chosen a different tune. Some of you big band aficionados know that during the war, Miller volunteered to go into the Army, actually the Army Air Force, on the basis that he could bring back and form a band from the fellows that were already drafted and were dispersed all over Europe. They gave him a commission, they made him a captain, and that's precisely what he did. And he spent a great deal of time, at least a couple of years, entertaining the troops. Now, he had a propensity of taking marches and making them swing tunes, and making swing tunes marches. Along those lines, there was a swing tune in those years, in the 40s, called the St. Louis Blues, which Glenn Miller decided, we're going to make a march, and instead of the troops passing by in review to the John Philip Sousa marches, which had been in existence since World War I, they went marching to the St. Louis Blues March, which supposedly pleased everyone. So we're going to perform the St. Louis Blues March exactly as Glenn Miller did it back in the 40s.
One, two, three, and... Thank you.
That was the St. Louis Blues March as performed by the Glenn Miller Band around 1942-1943. Well, during that time of the big bands, certainly another very fine band that was around was the Artie Shaw Band. Artie Shaw was kind of a strange fellow because he would put together a very fine band, they would perform for 6 months, and for whatever reason, he would disband it. And then he would start up again, and he would disband it. This probably was a way of life because Artie Shaw also had eight wives, one of which included, of course, I believe was Ava Gardner. So the man liked change. Now, one of his famous tunes was Begin to Begin, and for many years it was a classic, but fairly recently, Doc Severinsen and the Tonight Show Band decided to go into the recording studios, and he put together several CDs entitled The Best of the Big Bands. Instead of playing the arrangements that these fellows back in the 40s played, he modernized them. So we have something here that was arranged for him and the Tonight Show Band of Begin to Begin, which was Artie Shaw's big number. And the arranger, phenomenal arranger by the name of Bill Holman, did so. And of course, this became very popular, as a matter of fact, several times on the Tonight Show, Carson permitted him and the band to play this. So we're going to play this recent arrangement of Begin to Begin as performed and recorded by the Tonight Show Band and Doc Severinsen.
All right, let's move. 1, 2, 1, 2, 3. Thank you.
And that's the way Begin to Begin is done in the 2000s year, as opposed to 1940. Now, those of you that follow certainly bands and entertainment and go to performances know that singers have become very prominent members of the entertainment business, certainly with bands, much so that they more or less are the highlight as opposed to the band, where years ago the band was the highlight and the singer was kind of like the add-on. Well, we're going to have two different vocalists for you today, one for each set, both members of the band, which means they are multi-talented. We're going to present our first vocalist, and he's back there playing piano, Charles Henry. Yeah. And he's going to do this tune for you called Fly Me to the Moon, which I think you know was made probably very popular by Frank Sinatra. One, two, a one, two, three, and. Fly Me to the Moon. I guess I'll introduce the second one for him. Certainly, if you've been to a wedding recently, or even for the last 10 years or so, and a very popular tune is called Just the Way You Are.
Don't go changing to try and please me. You never let me down before.
Just the way you are. Well, Charles is going to take us back to Frank Sinatra again for his next number. Tune, certainly you all recognize, called I've Got You Under My Skin. I'm sorry. Wrong one. Getting old is not fun. Instead, we're going to do, thank you, Ben, Night and Day.
One, two, three,
wherever I go. With that roaring traffic boom, in the silence of a lonely room, I think of you.
That, of course, was Night and Day. Once again, our singer, Charles Henry. That's it. Well, we're going to change the pace a little bit. We are considered to be a swing band, and it's closely related but different in a sense from jazz. But there was a ballad called My Funny Valentine, which of course is a holiday that most recently passed. And kind of in commemoration with that, what we want to do is our rendition of My Funny Valentine. All jazz artists, at some point or another, played this too, on their way up or whatever. Everybody played this at one point or another. It was such a popular tune. And it's a very nice tune. It's a very pretty tune. I also want to take this as an opportunity to show that a band of this size can also play very pretty. So here goes our rendition of My Funny Valentine. One, two, three, and...
Bye.
My Funny Valentine. And that one is for many of my friends who have passed on, who are great performers, great jazz musicians, and certainly played this so wonderfully. We're going to turn our attention, as we close our first set, to a fellow that started his band in the late 50s, when other bands were pretty much declining and more or less were through because of the advent of what we call rhythm blues, which eventually segued into doo-wop music and doo-wop groups. And probably some of you may remember that in your youth. A fellow by the name of Maynard Ferguson. He came from Canada and took New York and America by storm. He played in Stan Kenton's band, and obviously was influenced by Stan Kenton. And he put together this big band, but his idea was not to play the traditional big band music that everybody had heard. He kind of tried to mix it a little bit with things that were a little bit more current at that time. We're talking about now, late 50s and early 60s. Not quite rock, but a concept that was different from big bands. And he named this tune after a very popular place in Manhattan called Birdland. And of course, Birdland was a place where all the, what we call beboppers eventually went into play and do their thing. So this arrangement is from the Maynard Ferguson Library called Birdland.
One, two, three.
You've been listening to the Something Special Band. Think about us, fellas. It's okay. You ladies know what it is. I'll buy back to you. We're going to take an intermission of about 15 minutes. Once again, our vocalist on that was Mr. Charles Henry, back there on piano, doing double duty. We'll see you in 15 minutes, so please don't go away.
Okay.
You should answer them.
Yeah, are we still live before anybody?
What you still live?
It's Phil. No, yo, Phil. Phil. I think we're still live before anybody says anything.
That should be very appropriate. Good morning, gentlemen.
Test. Good.
I'm going to make sure I got it.
At the last minute, 3, 2, 4 weeks.
All right, hold on. We'll talk about it then. Next thing.
So we never do this. One half move, go straight to there.
No, we do go back. Play the first time.
No.
We go there.
Nope.
Wait a second.
So I'm going to put food into this thing.
Clear all that.
Guys, we're finished with Michael.
Oh, no.
Yes.
Extra Michael. Thank you.
Are you saying I did?
I think so.
Yeah, I see.
So when is this going to be on?
Steve?
It's going to be on YouTube.
On YouTube?
It'll be on my phone.
Okay.
Let me edit it so you can listen to it. Try to get me today to get the whole thing.
Because you have 8 measures.
Eight measures straight,
right?
Right into the W.
Who was lost and lonely, believing life was only a bit of a joke with you, with you. The meaning of existence, oh my love.
I'm not trying to put around, you know, getting too square all my good luck with your program.
Somebody
fell off. Who knows? But this is the right one. It's not the right one.
Now, you want to say something.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. Once again, you're listening to the Something Special Big Band. We're going to start our second set with a tune you all know. This was recorded in 1938 by the Glenn Miller Band at a place called the Glen Allen Casino right here in New York. Of course, it was in the mood, and it became very popular. All the bands played in the mood, but his arrangement of it, for some reason, took on, and that became the classic. As a matter of fact, among what we call nostalgia bands, In the Mood is the big band Bible. Now, once again, we're not going to play his arrangement of it, but rather we're going to do something that was re-recorded and rearranged by Doc Severinsen and the Tonight Show Band. And we like to say to our audiences, this is the way we play In the Mood in the year 2022, as opposed to 1938. Now, you have to bear in mind that Glenn Miller's band was a dance band. So much of his stuff was kind of very nice sounding and very conducive to certainly dancing. Doc Severinsen didn't care too much about that. He was out to swing. So this is what we call a real swinging arrangement of In the Mood.
One, two, three, four.
Thank you, sir. We got a round of applause. That's the singular of applause. Doc Severinsen's rendition of Glenn Miller's Famous in the Mood. We're going to change now and give you a more modern approach to some of big band stuff. A tune which is kind of like a gospel tune, so to speak. The tune is called Moanin'. And once again, the band is going to play really pretty and soft and come down from the excitement and the high notes and everything else and kind of change the pace a little bit. Hopefully you'll appreciate this.
My count, do not rush.
One, two, three, and one, two.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Well, we're going to change the pace again. In the 50s, when the big bands were pretty much on their way out, certainly New York was inundated with a tremendous amount of immigration from the Caribbean. And with that came their music, essentially things called the mambo and the salsa. And along with that was a very famous musician by the name of Tito Puente. I think he might have been called King of the Salsa. A salsa is a fast mambo. And certainly we want to do something along those lines because that became a very prominent thing. And even today there are many Latin clubs where you have Latin bands that are performing this type of music. Two we have in mind is a tune called Tito Oye Como Va. Oye Como Va. Oye, come on, si. Tito Puentes, Oyo, come over. Well, it's that time we've been waiting for this, and I think one of our musicians has been waiting for this. This gentleman is making his first public performance as our vocalist. We brought him out of the trombone section, and he's all set to go. Ladies and gentlemen, I introduce David Russell.
Thank you very much.
Dave is going to do a group of tunes that were actually performed by the Basie band when the vocalist was, in my mind, one of the greatest blues singers in the world, Joe Williams. The first of these is what?
Every day.
Every day.
Sure that.
Yep. Every day.
This is a real sad tune. This is what we call charcoal blues, as performed by Joe Williams and today by Dave Russell.
Let's do this.
Yeah, Dave. Tell about the next two, man.
Well, I'm glad you asked me about that.
All right.
If anybody's had a significant other and has tried to have an argument with that significant other, you know how futile that argument can be. And at the end of it, you end up just saying...
That's if you're a male.
I'm not going to go there. I'm not going to go there. It's we're in those times. And I'm not going to have my Twitter account blow up. Not because you ain't got Twitter. I got Twitter. So that, it's with that and no further ado, all right. Okay.
One, two, three.
Well, all right. Okay. You win. I'm in love with you. Well, all right. Okay. You win. Oh, baby, what can I do? I'll do anything you say. It's just got to be that way. Well, all right. Okay. You win. I'm in love with you. Well, all right. No time in the doghouse, I disagree. The next song is a Frank Sinatra song, and I just adore almost everything that Frank has done. I love Joe Williams.
But he did it with Joe Williams,
and it's a great song, All of Me. I used to sing this to my daughter.
Rhythm up front. 33 bars, you guys are in at 28 bars. All
right.
One, two, three.
I
see, I'm just a mess without you. Take these hooks, I wanna lose them. Take these things on, I'll never lose them. Oh, goodbye, leave me with eyes that cry. Why can't I live without you?
Ladies and gentlemen, all you viewers out there, David Russell.
Yeah.
Yeah, Dave. In the event you want to keep abreast of where we're at, you might check our website. I have a listing of where we're going to be performing in the next couple of months throughout the island. And I want to certainly give my thanks to Lee and Dell, because the easiest thing to do with this pandemic business is to cancel everything. And he opted to go along and present the show and give us a chance to perform for you. And I am certainly grateful to the Massapequa Library for this opportunity. Rather than taking the easy way out, I feel, obviously, as a musician, we did the right thing. So kudos to the Massapequa Library. Thank you.
Thank you.
In any event, if you check our website, it's something special big band, that's one word, .org. Something special big band.org, and that lists our upcoming events. Hopefully, I'll be able to fill that out so that it becomes a long list. In any event, we're going to get back to our program. And one of the famous big bands around in the 40s was, of course, Tommy Dorsey. And right behind Glenn Miller in so far as popularity, they both were pretty much the same kin. They were dance bands, and Dorsey had tremendous musicians. He was a bit of a character, but he had a great band. And a tune that he recorded about three times was Opus Number 1. He recorded it in the 30s, the 40s, and actually he was on television for a while when he reunited with his brother, Jimmy Dorsey. And they played it again in the 60s. In any event, we have a different arrangement from what he played, of course, and this is more or less akin to how Count Basie would have approached this particular tune. So once again, we're going to do kind of a variation. This is Count Basie's arrangement of Tommy Dorsey's very famous Opus Number 1.
All right. Good. 1, 2, 3, and
go.
Opus number one, Tommy Dorsey original, played by the Basie Brothers. Well, we're going to close with a rather interesting number because it gives the guys in the band a chance to demonstrate their jazz skills. This was certainly originally, believe it or not, Benny Goodman, when he had what he called a trio and then a sextet. And one of the members of that outfit was Lionel Hampton, who played xylophones. Hamp eventually went on to form his own band, and of course took this tune and made a big band arrangement of it. And forevermore, it's affiliated with Lionel Hampton. The tune is called Flying Home. Hampton was a very frugal man. He once left a half of his band at the airport because they were having a debate as to how much they were going to get paid in Europe. So he got annoyed, left half the band in New York, took the other half, and then hired European musicians. When I called him to try and get some of the arrangements for him, I was always like walking on thin ice because I never knew, was it a good day or a bad day? And fortunately, I caught him a good day. And he said, what do you want? I said, well, flying home, and there's another tune called ML Express. He said, you want anything else? And I should have jumped at it, but I didn't want to, you know, I didn't want to kill a good thing. I said, no, I'll talk to you down the line. As it so happened, I waited 1 week, 2 weeks, 3 weeks, and finally, about 4.5 weeks later, I get this package of the music. Now, I didn't even know this existed, but it was sent to me fourth class. Now, I have some of my members in the band did work with the post office, and I never really got an explanation what fourth class means. But I know with Hampton, it had to be possibly the cheapest way you could send it. And lo and behold, a little after he had a fire and lost all of his music, and he then called me and said, could you send me anything? And he said, I'll send you what I have, but I only have two of your charts. So he was scuffling around to try and get his library together. In any event, this seems to be very appropriate as a closer. Tune called Flying Home. Thank you. Flying home, ladies and gentlemen. And I'm suggesting you're driving home, make sure you have a car. You've been listening to the Something Special Band. Please take a bow, fellas. Once again, thank you. Thank you to the Massapequa Library, to all of you out there. Hopefully we'll see you some way down the line. Again, the name of the outfit is the Something Special Big Band. Good luck and good health, and hopefully we'll see you sometime during the year. Have a good afternoon. Okay, guys.